Hey everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video, you'll learn how to copy cuts from one track to the next. There are many practical uses of this functionality, including cutting up a flattened offline clip in order to match it up to an online conform. You could also copy the cuts onto an empty gap track in order to make virtual VFX clips above each segment in your sequence. The list goes on, but in order to copy the cuts, the workflow is the same in each instance. This workflow is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. Now to show you how quickly you can copy cuts between tracks, here you have an edit assembled in a conform sequence. On another reel in the Reels group, you have a flattened offline video-only version of the edit, which you will use to perform a visual continuity check. So drag the clip from the reel and drop it onto a new track in the sequence. It doesn't really matter what kind of video track. Copy cuts will work on both video layer tracks or video version tracks. So you can see that the editorial is on the bottom track, and you would like to copy the edits or transitions from the bottom track to the top track. You don't need to select anything. All you need to do is call up the contextual menu over the edited bottom track and choose Copy Transitions to Track. Here you can choose the target track that will receive the cuts. Choose track V1.2. Instantly, all the cuts are copied to the track, and the single long segment is spliced into smaller segments matching the track below. As I mentioned at the beginning of this video, you could apply these cuts to gap clips as well, if you want to create virtual segments of the edit. So this has plenty of uses. Now let's expand on the functionality a bit more. I'll delete the top track so that we can start again. This time, you have another offline edit, but this clip has got synced audio. As before, you'll drag the clip from the reel to the sequence and add the segments to new tracks. So the difference between this example and the original is that this example has linked elements. In this case, it's audio and video. Now, when you have segments that are linked and synced, when you call up the contextual menu over the edited track and choose to copy transitions to track, you choose any of the target tracks and the cuts will be copied to all the linked segments. So in this case, the cuts splice both the video and audio tracks. If you didn't want linked tracks to be affected, just disable the link button to the right of the interface before copying the cuts between the tracks. Finally, I also want to highlight the extra flexibility as well as granularity of the copy cuts function. So as the last example, we'll start again with the online conform as it was, but this time we'll add a couple of dissolves between a few segments. As before, I'll grab the video only offline and add it to the track above the conformed edit. Now let's say for argument's sake, you want to copy the cuts like you've done previously. However, there are dissolves in the edit, and to make it more challenging, you only want to copy specific cuts to the target track. So all you need to do is select the cuts you want to copy. Hold Ctrl and multi-select the cuts. Once more, call up the contextual menu over the track, and now you will see Copy Selected Transitions to Track. So when you select transitions, you will get this option in the contextual menu. Choose the video track again. When you look at the target video track, you can see that the transitions were copied, including the dissolves, but only the selected cuts were copied to the target track. So copying cuts can affect an entire sequence, or you can be as granular as you like. And if you're using other transitions instead of cuts, they will be copied as well to maintain your editorial consistency of the sequence. Please be sure to check out the other workflows, features, and enhancements to the Flame 2018.3 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.